I'm Patrick Fisher, the Executive Director of Erie Arts and Culture. I also happen to be a resident of the Our West Bayfront. Today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about public art. Public art takes many different forms, from murals, mosaics, to sculptures, and even street furnishings. Some forms of public art can be easy to find because of their scale, such as the mural of Rudy over at the intersection of Sassafras and West 8th Street, while others might be hidden on back streets, such as this piece here on West 3rd, on the backside of the Martin Luther King Center. The reason I love public art is because it's a little bit like a scavenger hunt. You know, you can come across these pieces that you've maybe never seen before and be impressed by their scale and their color and vibrancy, and then try to go online and find out more about the artists or community members that participated in the making of the murals. The mural behind me here was made by Tom Ferraro and Ed Grout through a teaching artist residency funded by Erie Arts and Culture. With Tom and Ed's practice, they always look to engage the community and have them be a part of the making. So this piece in particular, the youth at the MLK Center helped design the piece, make the piece, and really control the narrative of the piece. Some pieces of public art, such as this one, are a little bit more abstract in nature, while other ones, such as Aaron Knapp's mural on the Cascade Club, is a very literal depiction of Erie's history, specific to the Bayfront. So public art can be something that is just bold and colorful and adds some vibrancy to the neighborhood, but it can also be something that is a narrative that helps share the community's identity. And those are all the reasons why I really enjoy public art.